Yes, sir.
I was wondering why you chose to just do some several specific battles instead of doing maybe some other battles, like, for instance, when you talked about when they were invading Saipan, Tinian, and Guam, you really only focused on Saipan. You didn't really talk that much about Guam and Tinian. So, why did you do that?
You know, this is a great question. It goes to the heart of almost all the questions that we've been talking about, and it's actually to the point. We realized that there was no way we could tell the whole story. There's no way we could be short of an encyclopedia or having a story read like the telephone book. And of course, the telephone book is not a story, to list and do justice to everything. So we thought that the way to do it was to find these four towns, find whoever came up to us in those four towns who could talk about it, and then we would just try to weave a story of the Second World War from their experiences. So what it was is, we had someone who was there at Saipan, and we didn't have anybody at Guam. And so we don't do a lot of different things, just as in our baseball series, we couldn't tell every World Series. In our Civil War, we couldn't tell every battle. And so what I'm saying is that I think that we begin to understand that all of them were horrific. And if we got enough of a representative sample, you could get a sense of what it was like. It can no way be encyclopedia. And we apologize if you've got, you know, interest in a specific battle like Tinian or Guam, which are all very interesting, or other places that were not even mentioned. But we felt it was the only way. I mean, we're still pretty thrilled, we have to tell you, that we have a 450-page book and a 15-hour documentary, and the biggest concern is what we've left out.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stay in your seats for a moment. I'd like to introduce the eminent Librarian of Congress, Dr. James F. Billington, also author of a fabulous book, Fire in the Minds of Men, that was very important to me many years ago when I read it. Dr. Billington would like to come up and say a few words.
The first words to say, although you've already said it with your applause, is thanks to all the wonderful authors that have read, and most particularly for a thrilling climax that was elicited as their series and their books will an emotional as well as an intellectual response from all of us. So I want to say a special note of thanks to our friends and our activators, not only of our consciousness, but of our consciences here. So, Ken and Jeffrey, thank you very much. Let me add just briefly that the questions focused on the need to tell more of the story. That's been beautifully answered, that you have to choose. But at about the same time that this has been going, their preparations and their work on this series has been going on, Congress has mandated the Library of Congress, on whose behalf I speak as I close out these ceremonies, to be gathering in stories. And it's a great tribute to them that they are tacking on reminders here that the Veterans History Project, which is already the largest oral history project in American history, is an attempt to gather in all these stories that remain to be filled out with a wonderful example of what these two marvelous historians have done. So let me just add that it's a wonderful thing for young people to interview these old. So in your neighborhoods as you return, wherever you are, not only try to find and get a story while there is still time, all these veterans, so that we really have the full story, as we've never had before, of not only this war, but all the other wars in the 20th century. That was a unanimous mandate from the Congress of the United States, but we need everyone's help. So you too can be Jeff Horitz and Ken Burns. And above all, there's something about the young rediscovering the sacrifices, the experiences, the richness and the sadness of war and of the this important part of the human experience. So I urge you, get your schools, make it a school project, and we will keep them carefully. And we do need your help and others' help to gather in these stories while still there is time, so that the many requests people always make, well, why not this, why not that, why not everything? So please help us with this, and we'll be happy to help. Now I want to thank you, the American public, for joining us in such rich numbers for the National Book Festival. It's a major outreach to the Library of Congress, a year-long effort, and I just want to pay a little tribute to the people who planned and executed, to many library employees, Sue Siegel, Roberta Stevens, Laura Kells, an active planning team spearheading this event with the help of many Library of Congress volunteers. Those yellow shirts you see are the sign. Mrs. Bush, our gracious host and guiding spirit, and her staff members, Anita McBride and Kirsten Mendo, work closely with us almost year-round to make this another successful festival. I want to thank the man upstairs for the good weather as well. And I want to thank the sponsors of the National Book Festival for making it possible. Target as our distinguished benefactor, AT&T, the Heyman Group, and the Washington Post as charter sponsors, AARP, the Institute of Museum and Library Services, the Library's James Madison Council, and the National Endowment for the Arts as patrons. I wish to also thank the Junior League of Washington for sending again this year a large contingent of volunteers, as well as the library staff itself, 500 members of whom in these yellow shirts dedicated their volunteer time, which they could have otherwise spent on this beautiful day, doing something else. So we really do thank all of these people. And I hope that today's events, we all hope, have sparked your imagination, renewed your interest in reading. We'll encourage you to continue to support reading programs in libraries across the nation. There's no problem we face today. There's more education, more reading, more concern of all of us for this wouldn't help. And there's no better place to begin than to recall these past memories that we've evoked so well as our concluding effort for today. So thank you all for being here. And
please step back, step to the side.